values, which is just your darks and lights. So without color, just your scale from light all the way to dark, how important that is in a painting. So it's just as important as color in making your painting successful. So what do you do to make it easier to see if you have a full value range all the way from light to dark of at least 5 to 10 values? Well, you can put a red tinted film over anything that's colored, and now you can see my entire color wheel has just gone into black and white. And this is very useful because I can now look at how light or dark any color is without the interruption of the actual color itself. So the color might trick me into thinking it's lighter or darker, but as soon as I put a red film down on top of it, then all of a sudden I know that something is a value 10 or a value 9 or a value 2 or 3, and I have absolutely no confusion. So this is very useful. And you can do this for any color painting that you are working on or any color wheel that you have created. Just like the red film, these color evaluators will actually let you see just the values without the color confusing you. Here's just an ink piece that I did, and you can see with this ink piece that because it's already in black and white, it's very easy for me to look at this entire thing and say, well, that's a low value, that's a dark value, and I have a few colors in between. So it looks like I have at least 5 values here, including all the way from light all the way to dark, which is what I'm looking for. So what do I do for a painting like this, which is in color? Now I can gauge with just my eyes that I see lights and darks, and this is usually pretty accurate. And if I squint at it, I can see with just my eyes if I have darker and lighter values too. But if I don't want to squint, or if I want some help, just in case I've been looking at this painting for too long and I'm confused about the values, again, I just get this red film, I put it down on top of this, and it turns it into a black and white piece. When you take drawing classes, as many of us have, you do all sorts of boring exercises at the beginning that include drawing all sorts of things well, just to make sure you can draw. So let's just say I want to talk about colors and not about numbers because that's confusing. So if I go all the way from white all the way to dark, you can see that there's 5 values here with the white, the completely dark black, and then the 3 values in between. I've found that even though there are 10 values usually on a value scale, and also our eyes can see tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of values, you don't want to get bogged down in trying to recreate all of these values. Choose the strongest values. You'll find that your illustration or your painting actually becomes stronger because it helps you read form. So one of the reasons these shapes are successful as a sphere, a cube, and a cone is because they are showing a full value range from lightest light to darkest dark. So with these 5 values, paying attention to making sure I have these 5 values from the white to the dark and these 3 shades in between, I now have a very convincing sphere, cube, or cone. And as a result of that, I can have a prettier painting or illustration. Now, sometimes you want to work in just high key, which means that you don't want to have very many middle or dark ranges, or sometimes you want to just work in a very low key, which means you want to have very dark colors and not have any lights or middle values. But you want to be able to work with a full value range when you need to. This feels so old, but again, I have this composition where I had to choose 4 shapes and make sure that one of them was very light, one of them was a mid tone or a middle shadow, and then a darker tone, and then a darkest dark. And that helps me make sure I have a full value range in just my composition. Making sure I had very light, very dark areas, and the middle dark, and then the lighter shadow. And again, it seems like once you have those 4 or 5 values down, you'll have a convincing painting, which is really exciting because you would assume that it actually means that you have to do tons of values, but it turns out that stuff looks more realistic, much more realistic, if you use those 5 values instead of trying to do a ton of values. And you can see, again, that one of the reasons this sheet should hopefully look realistic is because I've got very light highlights and very dark shadows, and also the three other tones in between. Now, here's an example of one that I did not get a very good grade on, and no, this bust was just as ugly, so it's not like I didn't draw the bust well. This bust was just as ugly here as it was in real life. The problem is that when I did this several years ago, I made the darkest dark back here look just fine. It's that in this actual face, there's only mid-tones. If you come back to it days, or preferably weeks later, you can actually see where the problems are. So I can definitely see now, years and years later, that I did not make that strong enough. Problem was, again, my values. If you want to just do stuff in high key or middle key, that's fine, but in order to make your teacher happy, you do have to convince them that you can go really dark, and I can see that my teacher probably thought that these weren't dark enough, so. I hope this has been useful to you. Looking at some of my really old junk from years ago in drawing classes, and I think that, again, if you focus on values and make sure you have a lightest light, a darkest dark, and focus on 5 to 10 values instead of doing more values than that, then your picture will be clear and very striking and beautiful. And if you don't focus on values or use too many values, then your picture will be confusing and not as beautiful. Painting is like life. As long as you get your values right, everything else is easy. So I'll leave you with that.